He's saying that Jesus Christ, peace be, is going to come again, and we agree with that. But since he's going to come again, he is the last Rasul according to the Quran and Hadith. He says, according to Islam, Isa alayhi salam is the last Rasul. I asked the brothers to show me one verse anywhere in the Quran which says Isa alayhi salam is going to be the last Rasul. He'll never find any. I challenge him. Point number one. Nowhere does the Quran say or the Hadith says that Isa alayhi salam is the last Rasul. I do agree that the Quran says in several places there are no less than 70 Sahih Hadith mentioning Isa alayhi salam is going to come back again. So nowhere does the Quran ever say. He said that according to Islam, Isa alayhi salam is the last Rasul. It is totally wrong. Nowhere does the Quran say Isa alayhi salam is the last Rasul. Quran says Isa alayhi salam is the Rasul. I agree. The Quran says Isa alayhi salam will come back again. No less than 70 Sahih Hadith that Isa alayhi salam will come again. But just by adding A plus B and making it C, this is your misunderstanding, which I'll clarify, inshallah. No two verses of the Quran can contradict. Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 432, Afala is the burun al Quran. Wallahu qana min indigarilla, la wajudu fiktilafan kasira. That do they not consider the Quran with care? Had it been from anyone besides Allah, there would have been many contradictions. So Quran cannot contradict. Two verses of the Quran cannot contradict. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Ahzab, chapter number 33, verse number 40, Ma qana Muhammadun aba ahadim mirjalakum, walakhir Rasulullah, wa khatamun nabiyin, wa qana Allah bi kullishin alima. That Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the father of any of you men, but he is the messenger of Allah, Rasulullah, and he is the Khatamun Nabiyin. He is the seal of the prophets. Allah is most knowing, full of knowledge. Now if you analyze, people don't know the meaning of Rasul and Nabi, and they mix up. The brother said, what is the meaning of Rasul? He asked. Didn't reply. Comes from the root word, Rasala, message. Rasul in English means a messenger, the one who gives a message. But in context, it means one who gets the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah. Rasul means a messenger. Even you and I can be a messenger, but not a messenger of Allah. Fine? After Surah Azab has been revealed, chapter 33 verse 40, anyone who says that he is a messenger of Allah or Nabi of Allah, he requires a psychiatrist. Quran is clear cut. Now, let's analyze when the Quran says, people have a misunderstanding, especially the Qadianis. The Qadianis have a misunderstanding. They say that the Quran says Khatimun Nabi, but not Khatimun Rasul. So what they say, Rasul is a person who is a prophet of God. And Nabi is a person who has got a message from God. That means a prophet who brings a message. They are interchanging the two meanings. Nabi means actually prophet. And Rasul means one who gets the Risala, who gets a message. So if you know a little bit Arabic, Rasul is a messenger. Messenger means a prophet of God who has been given a message, a wahi. So all prophets of God are not Rasul. But all Rasuls are prophets of God. All those who pass the HSC, that is standard 12, they have to pass standard 10, then only can they pass standard 12. If I say that a person is 12 standard pass, or a MA, Master of Arts, it's understood he's also a bachelor in some or the other field. If he's not a bachelor, he can't get master's degree. Understood. So when I say masters, I don't have to even write after MA, BA. It'd be foolish for me to write BA. MA is understood that you're also a bachelor in one of the fields. But if I say BA, it means he has not done MA. If I write only BA, if I had half the degree. Now here we realize that same way if I say that no one from today will pass standard 10, it's taken for granted no one will even pass standard 12. If I say from now onwards, no one will become a bachelor of arts, it's taken for granted no one will even become master of arts. Because first you have to go to low level, then go to high level. It's simple logic. So similarly, when Allah says Khatimun Nabiyin, means the seal of the prophets, is understood that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last prophet, last Nabi, as well as the last Rasul. But if the Quran would have said he is Khatimun Rasul, means the last Rasul, then there are chances he is the last Rasul who has got a wahi. There may be other prophets who will come who will not get a wahi. So because of lack of Arabic language, people twist it, and that's what the brother said. What is the meaning of Rasul? He asked the question, I'm giving the reply. Rasul means a messenger. In context, Rasulullah means the messenger of Allah. So it is clear cut, Quran cannot be wrong. But the Quran also says that Isa alayhi salam is going to come, which We agree. There are no less than 70 Sahih Ahadith mentioning that Isa alayhi salam will come. He's also mentioned that he'll come again in the Bible. There's no dispute on that. No Muslim disagrees with that. But the misunderstanding is, when he comes again, he will not get any new message. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last Nabi and the last Rasul. Where is the question of another Rasul coming? So when Isa alayhi salam will come, he will not get any new message. Because Allah says in the Quran in Surah Maida chapter 5 verse number 3, I have complete my favor on you and chosen for you Islam and complete the religion. That means the deen is complete. Nothing new can be added or subtracted from the basic fundamentals of Islam. So how can a messenger come after a deen is complete? Before the Quran was revealed, we had to follow the messenger of that time. But after the Quran was revealed and the last revelation was given, after that nothing new can be added or subtracted from the basic fundamentals of Islam. So when Isa alayhi salam will come, he will not come as a messenger getting a new message. What will he come? He will come as the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will follow the Quran. He will come why? What is the reason that he is the only prophet of Allah who Allah has raised up alive? Why? The reason is because all the prophets of God that came as a whole, before they expired, the people as a whole accepted that messenger to be a messenger of God as a whole. But Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, his people, they mistook him that he claimed divinity. So that's the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised him up alive. And that was mentioned in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 116, 117. On that day when I come, I will testify. I never said worship me, but I said, Ubudullah, worship Allah, Rabbi wa Rabbukum, who is my Lord and your Lord. Same thing in the Gospel of Matthew, it's mentioned. On that day when people will come and tell me, O Master, O Lord, did we not do wonders and miracles in your name? So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, say, E men of iniquity, E sinful people, I don't even know you, you depart from here. So here, even in the Bible, even in the Sahih Hadith, even in the Quran, he will come back again to testify to the people. He never claimed divinity. His messengership is over. He will not get anything new in Islam. Whether he comes or not, for us in the message, not even an iota will be added. But because Quran clearly says he will come, he will be a sign for the Qiyamah. Before the world ends, he will come. He will break the cross. He will kill the swine. Very Sahih Hadith. But that doesn't mean he will come and give us a new message. His messengership is finished. Khatam. Over. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came. The Quran has been revealed completely. Nothing new will be added and subtracted. Adeen is complete. So there's no confusion. Those people who don't understand Arabic and don't know the full knowledge of Hadith and Quran may give all these things to say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to deny any Rasul of Allah is kufr. I agree with him. But to say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the last Rasul is a bigger kufr. So if you say any time after this that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the last Rasul, is not the last Nabi, you become a kafir. In ignorance you said it, maybe Allah will forgive you inshallah if you ask for forgiveness. But after now, if you ever say again that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the last Rasul, or if you say he's not the last Nabi, it's kufr. You become a murtad. Has this point been noted? That anyone who says Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the last Rasul, Isa alayhi salam will come back again. But nowhere does the Quran say he will come and get us a message. He will come as a Rasul. Nowhere. I challenge him to show any hadith. The hadith say he'll come back again. Isa alayhi salam will come back again. But to testify to the Christians, he never claimed divinity. He'll come to kill the Dajjal. He is a sign of the Qiyamah. It is not that he will come and give us a new message. Otherwise the Quran is wrong. Otherwise we have to disregard the Quran. The Quran says, if you find any contradictions, it is not the word of God. And alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah, there are many people, I know Qadianis and some of the deviant sects of Islam, who try and prove their point by catching fish, using some Arabic words which the masses don't know, like the Qadianis. They come and they try and catch fish. There are many new groups starting up, you know, and trying to misguide the people, but the Quran is explicitly clear, alhamdulillah. So anyone who says Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not the last messenger is not the last Rasul, he is doing kufr. Anyone who denies that Isa alayhi salam is not the messenger is also kufr. But anyone who says he'll come as a messenger after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is also doing kufr. Because Quran clearly states that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last Nabi in Surah Ahzab, chapter 33, verse number 40.